Angeles back at Bankers Life Fieldhouse, and we just saw the Iowa Hawkeyes beat the Purdue Boilermakers on the second game of the tournament with a close game, and it ended at 87-80.
You know, and I gotta say, last night's game against Illinois compared to today's game, two completely different games. Night and day. It was insane. This game was so much more fast-paced right off the gate, and the physicalness of the game was way at a whole nother level.
It was so physical. Iowa had three girls coming off the court, kind of limping and bumping around. Disterhoff, Till, and Kastanik all came off the court just not feeling so great.
We came in knowing that they were going to play very physical. I mean, it's the Big Ten tournament, and you're probably not going to get a lot of calls. And after I hit my head on that chair, I was a little out of it for a bit, but just came back in, tried to play aggressive. And I think our team did a great job of adjusting in the second half to, you know, how the officials were calling the game.
Yeah, it's always frustrating, especially when you think that there should be a call there and there's not. But you just can't worry about those kind of things. You can't control what the refs are going to call, so you just have to worry about the next play and forget about that.
Crowd was a huge part of this game today. Mm-hmm. Both sides behind the benches were filled, and I think Both teams during the game were getting frustrated at times, especially for Iowa. I think coming from behind towards the end there, the crowd was a huge part of that.
Yeah, they really helped. They were really getting into those foul calls and everything. They just really helped, I think, Iowa get that win today.
And here's what Bluder had to say after the game.
We lost them by 1 point at their place. Those are the ones you just want to get back. We had that opportunity today, and it feels really good to have this one back. And, you know, we survived a lot of things out there. We survived some foul trouble. We survived a poor shooting night by a couple of our players in the first half, and they regrouped and came back in the second half, just what you want them to do this time of year.
And speaking of completely different games, Taylor and Logic showed up a lot more than they did yesterday. Logic had 12 points today in comparison to her 5 yesterday, and Taylor had 17 compared to her 8.
Yeah, they matched up perfectly when the Triple D came back, and they weren't around in the first half at all. But the second half, they did come back, and, you know, they got in the flow. The starting five, it finally happened. So, but in the first half, let's talk about how they got completely knocked out. So, figuratively and literally.
It was insane. Dixon got knocked out with 4 fouls with 10 minutes left in the second half. Disterhoff literally got knocked out when she hit her head on a chair. And then just Doolittle just wasn't there. They just shut her down completely. She left the first half with 0 points.
Yeah, but the second half they did come around. Like I said, it was rough. Mm-hmm. It was a rough first half, but they did come back. And I have to say, a Taylor Triple D brought Logic back into the mix. Here's what the girl had to say after the game.
We always just take the open shot. If somebody else is open, they're going to take it. If I'm open, I'm going to take it. That's the kind of team we are.
I think we were a little bit more composed down the stretch. Obviously yesterday, got enough points. Obviously built up our lead enough. 24 turnovers isn't what we want to do. Got it down to 11 today, I think. So when you're down 7 with 12 minutes left, you know, you have to take care of the ball. You got to get stops, and that's what we did.
So hopefully that starting five can relax tonight and bring the energy tomorrow that they had today to face Ohio State tomorrow, who just upset Penn State, who was the number one seed of the tournament earlier today.
Yeah, here's what the girls had to say about tomorrow's game.
Just another win, I guess. We're kind of really excited after this one just because last time we lost against them, and we shouldn't have. But I think we're going to go out there with the confidence that we got from this game, the energy, and, you know, go out there and do the best we can.
Rest, get a lot of water, sleep early, because obviously you don't have too much time to practice. It's going to be more mental, just knowing our scouts, knowing our game plan, knowing their plays, stuff like that. Just resting up, getting off your feet as much as you can.
I'm glad to be here. I'm glad that our team is in the semifinals. You're going to have two teams that have both been here since the first day, so I hope that it's not too sloppy, because that's what you're going to worry about, 3 games in 3 days. Well, you know, we played in Cancun earlier, and we played 3 games in 3 days, and we played very well on our third day. So I think putting our players in those types of situations earlier in the year, we can draw upon that.
Well, that's all we got for you guys from Indianapolis. I'm Rach Bedell.
And I'm Taylor Axelson for Daily Iowa and TV Sports. See you guys tomorrow.